All right, what's going on, y'all? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Robert, and today we're gonna be taking a look at the Yeezy 450 Sender. But before we get into that, please do me a huge favor by dropping a like on the video and subscribing to the channel. I really do appreciate y'all coming through, watching the videos, and for all my return subscribers, thank you for all the support. Okay, so let's go ahead and get into it. Like I said, we got the Yeezy 450 Sender. I did get lucky and I hit on the Confirmed app. I know a lot of people, you know, wondering where I got the shoes from, where I get a lot of these shoes from, and it's the Confirmed app. I stand by the Confirmed app, man. I'm telling you, my luck on that app, like, is better than any other app, period. I've always said it, like, Confirmed, I rely on them a lot, so they've been good to me, so that's where I got these from. So let's go ahead and take a look. So, a little smaller box. If you haven't seen a 450 before, they're about half the size of the box of your normal, like, 350 boxes. So you got 450 on the top. And on this side, you've got your size tag information. And I picked this up in a US men's size 9.5. And we're definitely gonna talk about the sizing later because I'm kind of confused now, but stick around and we'll talk about, you know, the sizing and everything, okay? All right, so let's go ahead and open these up here. I've already taken one out, but you know, you got your Made in Germany sticker right there on the top, which is different than, you know, your other Yeezys that you may have seen before. All right, get this open, get one of them out here. But yeah, like I said, I got them from, the Confirmed app, hit on the raffle, right? And I wasn't really shocked, but here we go. There you go, Yeezy 450 Sender. Do me a favor and comment down below. Let me know your immediate first impressions, just trying to see, you know, how you guys feel about the shoe. Now, like I said, picked them up on the Confirmed app and I wasn't shocked, right? Because on Yeezy Supply, I actually got through on Yeezy Supply 3 or 4 times. Like, it was crazy. I'm like, are people not really going for this shoe, or have they fixed some issues with the Yeezy Supply website? I don't know. So whenever I get through on Yeezy Supply, I'm like, okay, I'm gonna hold out. I'm gonna try my luck with Confirmed because I, you know, have such good luck there. And also because I don't wanna pay that $8 shipping on Yeezy Supply when I can get it shipped for free from Confirmed. That's just me. But I got lucky and I hit anyway. So let's go ahead and take a look at it. There we have it, guys, the Sender. On the upper, you've got this, like, you know, obviously, you know, prime knit upper here in that Sender color. And I've been looking at this shoe, trying to figure out what color it looks like. And it looks gray to me, but it's almost like a grayish brown, got a brown hue to it. I mean, certain parts of it look gray, and then when you look at it in a different light, it looks kind of like a light brown color. But hopefully you guys can make that out there. Now, the 450 is one of those shoes. It's not an extremely popular model. I think with the more colorways they release, at least I'm starting to feel like that, you know, people aren't really, you know, feeling this shoe as much anymore. Now, I like that the first pair they released, the all-white pair, and then the black pair, I think it's the slate colorway, I think. That one was nice. And I also had the green one that dropped in December. So that was the only pair I had, but now I have these. But like I said, you got prime knit all over the upper there. And then the most obvious thing about the 450 is that kind of midsole that wraps up the side of the shoe. It looks like claws or some sort of like teeth on the side of the shoe that kind of holds your foot in place, which is a pretty wild design. And you know, looking at this shoe, you would think it'd be super uncomfortable. Now, I haven't worn my shoes like this out all day long yet to test out the wear and the comfort of it, but just putting them on your foot, you don't notice it as much. But we'll talk about that a little bit later when we get into sizing. So let's go ahead and take a look at the toe box. Just another look at that for you right there. All right, and then you got your rope laces here. This does not come with any extra laces. Just wanna call that out. All right, and then you got the ankle collar around here, which is pretty much like the, you know, just an elastic band here, like kind of like a sock or something. All right, let's take a look at the medial side of the shoe. And pretty much the same thing there. Just want to give you another look at it. And these tags here, you do have, like, you know, your standard size tag, but then you also have that made with recycled materials tag here. I don't know how they determine which shoe gets this or which ones they use recycled materials, or even how, you know, much of the materials are recycled. I just wanted to call that out because you get that kind of globe recycled logo on the insole. So just figured I'd mention it. Okay, let's take a look at the outsole. Here you have it, your standard 450 outsole there, and it's in that Sender colorway. This one doesn't look It's not really translucent. It's kind of got like a gum type look to it, but it's in that cinder colorway. All right. And the heel of the shoe. Not a whole lot going on there, but there you have it. Okay. Now that'll be about all, guys, for the Yeezy 450 Cinder. So, as always, I like to give my final thoughts on the shoe before we get into the on feet. So, is this a must-have? I'm gonna say no. I like this colorway. I'm kind of on the fence of whether or not I like it more than that. I don't remember the name of that green colorway, but yeah, the green one that dropped in December. I think I like that color. I don't know which one I like better, to be honest. I thought I liked this one a little bit because it looks gray and I feel like, you know, that colorway is a little more wearable. This one's a little more wearable, but I just don't know, man. The 450 is just one of those shoes that I still haven't worn the green pair that I have. Just don't really think it's a shoe that necessarily I have to have in my collection. So is it a must pick up? I say if you're a collector of Yeezys, then go ahead and grab it. I'm not sure what these are going for on the resale market. I would imagine probably it shouldn't be much over retail. I'm just gonna take a wild guess. Like I said, I haven't checked, but just by, you know, how it felt on release day, I just kind of guess around that. But I say, you know, if you can grab them, go ahead. But for me, I don't think it's like a must have. But let's go ahead and talk about the sizing of the shoe. All right, so sizing. I picked this up in a US men's size 9.5, right? Which is my normal 350 size, which is a half size up. And this shoe, when you put it on your foot, I have a slightly wide foot, you do feel just a little bit, you don't feel these individual like claws or spikes or whatever they are poking your feet or pinching them at all, but you do feel whatever material is underneath it kind of hugging the sides of your midfoot area a little bit more. And you do feel like a little bit more pressure in the arch area of your foot. So I will say that. I'm kind of shocked that the 9.5, you know, fits, right? Because I heard a lot of people talking about going up a full size and all this stuff because they fit really, really small. And when I heard that, I thought they fit, you know, small like lengthwise, right? And I'll say that like in a 9.5, my foot probably ends right about at the end of my finger here. So I've got just a finger's width of room in the toe of this shoe, which is kind of weird because I feel like, I know there's not a big difference between a 9.5 and a 10, and I picked up the green pair that dropped in December in a size 10, right? And lengthwise, they fit almost the same. There were no issues, but what I will say is that a full size up, you literally feel no pressure on the sides of your feet, none. So I hope that helps you out. So if you go a half size up, your normal 350 size, they will fit. Now you'll feel a little bit pressure, like I said, in the midfoot area. Oh, I almost forgot one thing. I think on both of my feet, but I felt it a little bit more on my right foot. There was like a little bit more pressure right along this area on my toes, on the top of my toes a little bit. Like right next to this claw, like right over in here, there was just a little bit more pressure. Now that could be the way my feet are shaped, or maybe there's like a material under here that's kind of pushing down a little bit more. It wasn't super uncomfortable, but you definitely notice it. I'll just call that out. So just to recap, half size up, they will fit. If you got a wide foot like me, you'll feel a little bit of pressure in the midfoot area as well as in the arch of the foot and maybe right here on the top. But like I said, if you had to go a half size up, you could do it. But just note, keep in mind, I haven't worn these like obviously for days at a time yet, so I'm not sure how they're gonna feel once you break them in and everything. But I do know if you go a full size up, you have no issues at all, and they don't fit super, you know, huge anyway. Like some people, sometimes you buy like the Quantums, for example. If you go a full size up in those, which I've done before, you get a lot of heel slippage. In this shoe, full size up, you don't get as much heel slippage, and there's no pressure points anywhere around your foot, so that's always good. So that was a lot. To recap, just a half size up or full size up if you want that really, really comfy fit. Okay, now that'll be about all, guys, for the Yeezy 450 in the Cinder colorway. Please do me a huge favor and drop a like on the video and subscribe to the channel. I really do appreciate you watching the video. Thanks again, and I'll see you next time.